Good evening. The grieving family of a little boy killed in a ferocious house fire in Brisbane's north has spoken publicly for the first time since returning to the gutted home. Six-year-old Max Shirilla should have been heading back to school for term two today. Instead, a shattered community is in mourning.
Returning to the fire-ravaged home where he lost his grandson, Paul Shirilla is holding on as best he can, but the grief is overwhelming.
Very bad, very bad. Thank you very much.
How does it make you feel seeing the support for the family?
It's all right. No can recover the boy. The house is like house.
A day on from the devastating blaze which claimed the life of little Max Shirilla, the raw, unbridled emotion outside the family home was gut-wrenching. Among the mounting pile of tributes, a school hat with a note reading, "Hope you sleep well in heaven." The six-year-old should have been joining his friends for the first day of term two.
It's a very sad, you know, situation that you walked in, everybody's just quiet. You can't see that excitement of the first day at the school after the new term, you know.
In a statement, Ascot State School said the community is deeply shocked and saddened by the tragic passing of one of its students. Guidance counsellors are at the school to provide support in any way they can and for as long as it is needed. A sentiment echoed by the Education Minister.
But the department will be at that school and putting in place any assistance that the school community requires. As a parent, I couldn't imagine, it's your worst nightmare, and to the family and to all the friends, my sincere condolences.
Fire investigators were again combing the scene this morning as they try to determine the cause of the blaze. One avenue of investigation is whether an electrical fault was to blame. 10 News First understands there were a number of items inside the home which could have ignited. That will now be the focus of an inspection by electrical safety officers. As floral tributes continue to grow outside at the home, a GoFundMe page has already raised more than $35,000 to support the grieving family.
People are offering food, clothes, toys to the little brother. Yeah, it's good. I hope they can feel the love from the community.
As it mourns the loss of a little boy who had an entire life still to live. Samantha Butler for 10 News First.